Yeah, let us start. We started with this problem. S produces CC, capital C produces small CC, C produces D. This is the problem we started in the last class. Then we started finding first of S, first of S. Now, S dash produces S. We need to decompose this into different productions, including augmented production. Wait a minute, numbering is not to be done for this, only for this numbering to be done. Here, no need of numbering. Augmented production we need to add. S dash produces S. Same like the previous SLR. Now, only the change is second component, inclusion of second component. S dash produces dot S. Since it is augmented production, we need to include a special second component, dollar. So just because of this dot operator followed by non-terminal, we need to bring all its productions. Production starting with S, only one available. So we are bringing S produces dot CC. Dot followed by C. Dot followed by C is non-terminal, so we need to bring all its productions. Starting with C, there are two productions, so that we have brought these two production and we have placed a dot in front of this production, each of the production. We need to calculate for every production second component. How we need to calculate? Because of this symbol only, we have brought this. So we need to leave. Other than that, all other component we need to collect. We need to collect excluding that comma so that it is dollar. First of dollar would become dollar. We have written here dollar. Because of this, we have written here. This is by nature or by law or by the rule. We need to include dollar as a second component for the augmented production. That is unavoidable. Then rest all, we need to go for computation. We need to go for first computation. After the dot, whatever the symbol available, exclude that. Rest all you need to do here. Similarly, we need to do first computation. First of dot followed by capital C, rest all we need to include. If I include rest all, it would become this. Then first of C naturally would become C comma D. Look at here, one small correction or small emphasis I want to give. Here only one symbol C, already I have muted, once again people are unmuted. See, because of this C dot followed by this capital C only, we have brought these two productions followed by C as well. For all the C productions, we need to include CD, no need to compute step by step. Because of this C, first of C, we are going to compute first of C. Then this would lead to, so because of first of C, we need to include second component CD into both of the production. In the previous class, I said step by step you try to compute, not required. This is the only one correction or one emphasis I want to give. Capital C is the component starting in the first computation. So that C has two productions, so that we need to include CD, CD in both of the productions. That's all. This is what I wanted to start. So we did this. Now from here, we need to shift this dot operator on S. So upon S, shifting the dot operator, we reach to the canonical set I1. S dot dollar. Similarly, we need to shift this dot operator next to C, so that we are moving on the symbol C to the canonical set I2. So C dot, this capital C has only one production, but dot followed by C. Because of dot followed by C, we need to include all the productions of the form C produces. Second component, whatever is available, as such we need to copy paste, we need to carry forward. So dollar, compute, leave this symbol, compute first for the remaining, it would become first. Since the first production gives dollar, we are giving dollar here. Next we need to do the same dot C is available, so that all the C productions, whatever the first computation, we need to just take a replica, dollar dollar. See, look at dot C. Because of dot C, all the productions we have included, you need to compute first of dollar. You need to leave this symbol, first of dollar. So because of this dot C, all the C productions, you need to include same dollar. No need to compute again and again. That is the message I am giving now. Next is shifting this dot to the small c. So we are doing here dot C. Dot C is non-terminal. So we are including both of the productions. Try to compute the first of dot C. Leave this symbol, first of small cd. Then naturally it would become first of small d would become cd. So for both of the production, you may need to include small cd. You need to include small cd. Now we are shifting this dot operator next to the d. So shift this, whatever is available, write down. Now all the productions we have visited, I1, I2, I3, I4. Now we need to go for, this is ended, this dot operation ended. So this is related to accept, dollar accept. Next, I2, we need to shift this dot operator. Why you guys are unmuting unnecessarily? We need to shift this dot operator next to this C so that we are using capital C. Look at C, C dot, dot followed by nothing. So this complete computation stops. Next, this dot we need to shift to the small C. C dot followed by capital C. We need to bring this, then compute the first. Then first of this would become C, sorry, dollar. So that you need to include for all the productions the dollar. One mistake happened. This is not L, this is C. 1 minute. This is C. Capital C, not L. Yeah. D produces dot D replicated. Then again, you need to shift on dot D. If you shift, you reach to I7. Look at these productions. You need to shift dot C. You will be reaching I8. Again, you need to shift small dot C. Then you will be getting the same canonical set. Then you need to shift this dot to ID. You reach I4. Similarly, if you want to shift this small C, it goes to the same state. Capital C, it goes to new state I9. Look at LR of 0, LR of 1. Look, if you look at the first component, if you try to do for the same grammar LR1, LR0, you would be getting the same. That is what they are trying to tell. How it varies is with respect to second component only, it varies. All the components would become same as LR of 0 item, but different for LR of 1 item. That's all. Now we go to the table. Very first table we are going to do with follow as well. We need to find out follow. See, for this production, first is this follow of S is dollar, follow of C also dollar. See, why follow of C is dollar? Look at follow of C, nothing, follow of C, nothing. So we need to include naturally follow of S. So follow of S is dollar, follow of C is dollar. That's all. Nothing more you need to remember. Let us go here. How many states are available in this diagram? Total I9 state. Starting with I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7, I8, I9 state. So number of rows would become 0 to I9. How many terminals are there? As per given grammar, small c, small d, one special terminal, that is dollar, always we would be including this dollar. This is called action table. Next, all the non-terminals we need to collect, that is capital S and capital C, that is called go to table. So go to table. Now we need to fill up. As usual, how we are doing for SLR, similar way we need to fill up. See, S and C, it goes to 1 and 2 from I0. S and C goes to 1 and 2 so that it is written. Non-terminals means go to symbol. Then there are two terminals, C and D. Shifting this terminal C and D goes to 3 and 4. So S3, S4. We have written. Let us consider I1 state. I1 state, this dot has reached to the end. Since it is augmented production, we need to write accept. So that accept. Next, I2 state. If you look at I2 state, from I2, there are three outgoing labels. One on non-terminal, two are terminal. Let us look at non-terminal. I2 upon C, we need to write 5. See, look at I2 upon C, we need to write 5. That is what we have written. Then I2 upon small c, small d, shift 6, shift 7. I2 upon small c, small d, shift 6, shift 7. Then 3. Look at that 3 state. 1 outgoing edge on non-terminal, 2 outgoing edge on terminals. This C goes to 8. I3 C goes to 8. Look at here, 8. Next, I3 small c, small d. Small c goes to shift 3. Small d goes to shift 4. Shift 3 and shift 4. Next, fourth state. Let us look at the fourth state. Only one production, that dot also has reached at the end of the production. So we need to think of reduce production, reduce action. Then we need to go for identifying the number. So when I look at the number, this is the number. C produces D, 3, R3. I need to write down R3. See, this is one production, two production, three production. So that I am writing down R3. R3 to whom I am writing is the question now. R3 is written, C produces C, I4, C produces R3, I4, D produces R3. Both the symbol we need to write because look at this has two component. That is the beauty or use of this. C produces D. This has two components, so that we are writing. This is the only change. Please note a point. I4, it is a reduction production. We need to refer the number, that is third production, reduce third. To whom we need to write is your question. Now we need to write that reduced production for both of the second component. That is what? I4. Next, one more time you will understand. Nothing to worry. I5. Look at what is this production? S produces CC. Dot has reached at the end. Reduce action. Where? What is the number of CC? Look at. S produces CC is the number 1. So reduce 1. To whom to write? You need to look at the second component, dollar. For the dollar, you need to write down R1. This is the beauty. This is where it is called CLR of one parsing table. That is the use of second component. Now I am talking about CLR of one. Please be careful. I started with the LALR1. Now during the table construction, I am doing CLR. Again, I will come back to LALR. For the LALR, CLR is going to help us. That is a one small trick. I am combining both of the parser today itself. Look at now. I6, there are three outgoing edges. One is on non-terminal, two terminals. On non-terminal, it goes to I6, it goes to I9. Look at I6, it goes to I9. Go to table. Next, small c, small d. Small c comes back to sixth state. Small d goes to seventh state. Shift 6, shift 7. See, shift 6, shift 7, 9. Now, next state, I7. D dot, reduce action. Again, it is 3. This is third production. The R3. Whom we need to write? We need to write to the second component. Please be careful. Second component, dollar. See, look at R3. This is the small change we are introducing. Normally, R we will be filling for the entire row if it is of LR0. Then LR of 1 we are filling for follow computation. When it comes CLR, we need to fill that reduction symbol or reduction action only for the second component. That is the trick here, nothing more is a difference. Second component we have included, we need to use that second component. Logically, you need to question us also. Well, you have included second component, where you will use, how you will use. If you have that question, now I am giving answer. So all the reduce action only, we are going to use that second component. That second component we are writing down, that reduction action. So now R3 is over. Next I8. Look at the state I8. Only one production, I8. That also has reached. CC is the production number 2. Production number 2, reduce action 2. To whom we need to write? Second component C and D. Look at I8, production number 2, R2. To whom we are writing? C and D. Look at the next, I9. The dot has reached end. We need to write the reduce action. What is the production number? Again, production number 2. To whom we need to write? The second component. Second component, it is written $R2. Hope so you would be clear. If not, you can raise a question either in the audio note or you can raise a question in the chat window. Next, I'll be coming back to LALR. This table construction is the first step. This is how CLR works. If CLR doesn't have any shift-shift conflict, shift reduce conflict, then we can go for LALR. So this is the power of computation is CLR only. But the way to construct LALR is from the canonical table computation only, parse table computation only, we can do for LALR. This is intermediate step. If you have doubt, you can clarify. Now only 10 minutes trick we are going to apply. So what is a trick? Look at here. I will run through different steps. I will come back to this green color table, LALR table. See, look at. This is what we did. The diagram, whatever we have seen, it is written here. Explanatory. Whenever you are reading the material, you can understand without even watching the video. Look at, we are going to combine these three states, I36, I47, I89. If you look at all the double state, third state and sixth state, first component would be the same, second component only will be varying, so that we are combining those states. If you look at fourth state and seventh state, first component would be same, second component would be different. If you look at 8th and 9th state, first component would be same, second component would be different, so that we are combining these are all the state. Please understand this picture. I will make you to understand much more clear. Now, look, come back to the same diagram. 3 and 6 we have combined now. Look at the third state and sixth state. Look at I3, I6. Please pay your attention. Focus on these two states. Look at each and everything is same. First component, small c dot capital C, small c dot capital C, dot small c capital C, dot small c capital C, dot D, dot D. All the first components are same. Please pay your attention. Only the second component is same, different. I6, the second components are dollar. I3 second components are CRD, so that we are going to merge these two states, I3, I6. Similarly, look at 4 and 7. Look at the 4 and 7. See, look, 1, this is 4, 2, this is 7. Look at the first component, C produces D dot, C produces D dot. Look at the second component, dollar CD. These two states varies only with respect to second state, sir, second component. These two states are common with respect to first component. So we have the privilege to merge these two. Why we are merging? Time complexity reduction we are doing. We are reducing the size of the table. CLR table is larger. It will speed up than the previous parser, but LALR will help us to reduce the length of the table. That is the only difference. Look at I8 and I9. Look at the first component. Capital C produces small c capital C. Capital C produces small c capital C. Both of the state first components are same. It changes with respect to only the second components, dollar CD. So that, now look at, all the two states are merged together, 4 and 7, 8 and 9, 4 and 7, 3 and 6. So that it is written 1, 2, 3, 6, 4, 7, 5, 8, 9. Instead of 10 states, it's going to become 7 states. If you feel so difficulty in 36 and all, you can change it to one single state. You need to rewrite this diagram. This diagram you can relabel with different states. That's all. What we are doing, just we are merging those two states. Look at 3 has S3, S4. 6 also has S3, S1, 3 and 6 na? 3 and 6. 3, 6. We are merging so that these two together we are writing 3, 6. Then we are merging 4, 7 so that we are writing 4, 7. Wherever the 3 or 4 or 6 or 7 available, everywhere you need to replace by 3, 6. See, S3, S3. Since we are merging 3 and 6, we need to replace by 3 by S3, 6. We need to replace by S4 by S47, S6 by S3, 6, S7 by S4, 7. Look at the third state, S3 by S3, 6. This 3 also we need to replace by 36. This S4 by S4, 7. That's all. 4, 7. How it works, let us look at 4 and 7. R3, when we combine this, it will become R3. 8, 9, R2, here you have R2. When you combine, this would become. This is the way you are doing. Wherever the standalone number 8 is there, you need to write down 8, 9. You need to merge. 3 and 6 are merged so that it becomes 8, 9. That's all. This is the change in reduction of the parsing table happens with LALR. This is called CLR. Individually, you need to do. Only the reduction actions are different. In this table, reduction actions only will become different. That reduction action, you need to fill up the second component. 1 minute. I'll just write something. So in this diagram, what is this thing we are trying to do? Look at here. In the table, especially in this table, I'll bring here. Something went wrong. 1 minute. Deleted. In this table, reduction action we are doing with second component. All the time this R3 is written only for the second component. R1 is written only for the second component. R3 is written only for the second component. R2s are written only for the second component. Here R2 is written only for the second component. That is the first step. We are moving with CLR. So far now whatever we did, same for LALR, same for CLR. If you fill up like this, then it is called CLR. If the CLR doesn't have any shift reduce conflict. See, if you look at the table, every cell has only one entry, no double entry. Double entry means it is called conflict situation. Shift conflict is one, shift reduce conflict is second, reduce conflict is third. Three conflicts will come. In the case of CLR, if there is no conflict of these three, shift reduce conflict, then you are permitted to go for LALR by merging. That's all. This is a simple concept you need to understand at the end. CLR, LALR, canonical set computation. Let me come back to this. What is canonical set computation? This diagram. Data flow diagram or directed flow analysis or graph. For this or this particular state is same, common. Please understand. LALR, CLR, that entire step, augmented production, numbering the production, that DFA or data flow graph drawing, whatever, or directed flow graph, or deterministic finite automata, write whatever you want. These all would become, it will be deterministic. None of the label is having more than one label from the same state. So it is deterministic only. That is for sure. So call it anything. The diagram is same for CLR, LALR. Please understand that point. What is the second point? We need to first go for parse table. That parse table we are doing for CLR. This is called CLR. In this CLR, reduce action only differs. So far now, in the previous session, we discussed that reduce action is filled with follow symbol. Now, no need to worry about follow. We no need to even compute the follow. We need to fill up that reduce action for the second component of the productions. Whenever the dot has reached at the end of the production only, we go for reduce action. In that production, you need to look at the second component. For the second component symbols, you need to write the reduce action. Until then, it is called CLR, canonical LR. Now we are coming back to LALR. How we are coming is, you need to verify whether this, here I will write down, yeah, here I have a space. Reduce action is filled with second of the production. This is the thumb rule. This is one point you need to do. Next, if CLR does not have shift conflict or shift reduce conflict, shift conflict, if it is not existing, does not has, then we can construct LALR table by combining the states based on the first component. Differ with respect to the second component is not at all our botheration. It can vary with the second component. These are all the steps you need to understand. No shift conflict. No shift reduce conflict, no shift conflict. If there is no conflict in the CLR, you are permitted to go with LALR. These are all the three steps. Reduce action is filled with second component of the production. That's all. This is what I am trying to tell. Look at here. If you look at this diagram, third state and sixth states are same. Look at carefully. Second component only varies. Fourth state and seventh state, first component are same. Second component only varies. If you look at eighth state and ninth state, first component only varies. Second components differ. First components are same. Second component only vary. So we are going to merge I3, I6, I4, I7. I8, I9. These two states are merged together. After merging only, we are writing this table. Whenever you see 3, you need to write down 3, 6. Wherever, 3, 6, 3, 6. 6, 3, 6. 7, 4, 7. 4, 4, 7. 8, 8, 9. 9, 8, 9. Rewrite. First, rewrite as such in the table. Then you can combine. Then you will understand much more clearly. Let us go for quick revision, then we will stop it. See, these are all the states combined together. Separately, I am showing you. I36 combined. Why? Because first component is same. It differs with respect to only the second component. I47 combined, first component is same, it differs with respect to second component. I89 is same, it differs only with respect to the second component. So these states are merged. Now it is written. This is the original CLR table. Separately I am showing you. This is original CLR. This is LALR. See, merged. If you can't understand that, you understand this way. S of 36, S of 47. Wherever we are merging, you need to replace by with the respective numbers. Hope so this table you would be understanding much better. Now, what is advantage? There are fewer states. There is no conflict. There are no conflict. There are, what is a conflict? Three conflict. Shift, shift conflict. Shift, reduce conflict. Reduce, reduce conflict. There are three conflicts. There is no conflict at all. Then we can proceed with LALR. Now, look at all the combination together in a single table. Here, this is a output of the program. You do have laboratory, for that you need to do. See, whenever it is repeating, they have not written. You may not be able to understand. That is why I have broken the entire problem statement into several steps. So with these steps, we are reaching to the holistic review. The same only here available. Here it is avoided with 6. No computation with 6. Immediately it is replaced by 3. No computation for 7. It is replaced by 4. No computation for 8 and 9. It is replaced again. So with that reduced state, the table is written. This is the parsing, sample parsing action. For the string, a small string it is considered, small c dd. This is a string given to the parser. Using this parsing table, it does the parsing action. Whenever you are doing the parsing action here, you need to consider all the time 3, 6, 4, 7 at a time. 3, 6 is going to become a single state. It is not two state. 4, 7, whenever you see, whenever you are doing the parsing action, this is single state. Whenever you see 8, 9, it is a single state. So with that assumption, it is possible to do parsing action. So this is a holistic picture. There are a lot of problems solved in this link. If you go to this link, it has plenty of problems. See, these are all the links. I'll be shortly uploading. Today or tomorrow I'll be uploading, because unit 3, we are completed. Complete unit 3, only one document I'll be uploading. So if you look at SLR demo, LL parser demo, LR1 demo, LALR parser demo, it has animation, the complete output for the given grammar. But it will work for only one grammar. It won't work for whatever the grammar you change. If at all I'm giving assignment, you can't change the productions here, or else you try. If it allows you to give you a production set here, you can do with. So these productions are fed here. Then it will go for the canonical set, closure computation. Then it will go for states and go to action and kernels. These kernels, look, if you look at merged kernel, see what is a kernel is merged. After merging, the technical terminology is kernel. Before merging, the technical terminology is canonical set or closure computation. This is what LALR. Finally, LALR table. This is for parsing action. Maximum number of steps, simply they are giving a threshold to break. Suppose if it doesn't matches, something goes wrong, if the given input is not appropriate for the parsing action, it will get stuck up. So that they are giving some threshold condition, 100 steps. If you want, you can reduce to 25 steps also. See, look at this parsing action. Stops within 10, 12 steps, 13, 12, 14 steps. So this is the tree for this string small c, small dd. This is the tree diagram. This is the algorithm. Whatever we did, that algorithm is available here. This is what we started with. So whenever we want to do first computation dot b, we need to forget about the b. Remaining all beta and ab we need to write down. Then first we need to compute. That would become your first. So this is what, this is second problem. I think we may not be able to compute or complete it today. Let me start it, then we can continue the discussion in the forthcoming class, or you can take it as a assignment. I'll just walk through few steps. So this is a grammar. It has two components. We need to break it into two different components. This is assignment operation. Then star R, R ID. This has two productions. So decompose all the production, number it. And then you need to go for augmented production. So you are giving zero. So no problem. Zero we are not considering now. While reducing 1, 2, 3 only we are considering. So this is another method of doing. You can follow this method as well. No issues. You need to go for augmented grammar. After that, rest all the grammar you need to number it. So you are numbering with 1, 2, 3, 4. You are numbering this augmented grammar as 0 because never we use 0. It is for safety. Always you can compute first and follow so that you no need to waste time. That is the reason it is computed prior in prayer. So that come to this grammar. Look at if you feel so comfortable with this diagram, you look at, otherwise I will compute. So first production is augmented production. S dash produces dot S. You need to include dollar. Next, S produces dot S is non-terminal, so you need to bring all its derivatives. It has productions. It has two productions. S produces L equal to R. S produces R. Then you need to compute first of it. So first of dollar would become dollar dollar. That is what you are doing. Let us do here. What we are going to do, let me include SL. What is your first production? S dash produces S. You need to place a dot operator. I am placing dot operator. Dot second component is dollar. By default, you need to give dollar for the augmented production. Since dot followed by S non-terminal, I need to bring all the productions associated with S. There are two productions are associated with S. So that S produces L equal to R. I need to place a dot operator. Let us see the second component. Nothing to worry right now. Let me include the other production R. Look at this table. S has two productions, so that I have included. Now we need to go for second component computation. How we can compute? Dot followed by S. We need to leave. Rest all we need to consider. First of comma dollar. So this is what your first. Eliminate the dollar. Now what is your first of function? First of dollar. So you need to include dollar. S has two productions, so for both the production you need to include dollar. That's all. This is the step number two. Next, you need to place dot. Dot L, dot R. Dot followed by non-terminal, so you need to include all the productions related to L. L related productions are two. Star R. L produces ID. Then R related production, dot followed by non-terminal. So I need to bring all the productions related to R. R produces L. I need to place dot here. Dot followed by terminal, no more action. Dot followed by ID, no more action. Dot followed by L, already all the productions we have brought, so no need to worry. Now we need to go for second component computation. Second component. How we are going to compute, let us see. If you look at this production R, this has come because of this L. So we need to look at this. I need to combine L followed by whatever available. So first off, rest all I need to copy paste. What is the first of this combination? Come equal to. So I need to write equal to. For this also I need to write equal to, because there are two productions are associated with this, so that it is written. Look at here. R followed by first of dollar, so that second component would become dollar. Let us go and check. dollar, dollar, dollar equal to dollar. Look at dollar, dollar, dollar equal to R dollar, equal to R dollar, dollar. Why this equal to R dollar has come? Let us revisit. See, there are two first has come. Why it has come? This first of equal to R comma dollar, first of equal to R comma dollar, because of this production has dollar, we need to include this dollar as well. R dollar, R dollar. So this we have computed based on this equal to R comma dollar. We have computed equal to equal to. This is one method. Next method, what we need to look at this S producers. 1 minute, I'll come back to this step. Dollar only. Here we need to write down R dollar, R dollar. There are two first computation we are considering. Why? Because this is the combination we are combining and writing down first, equal to equal to. Next is this production has a first second component as dollar. Because of that, we are including the dollar, dollar as well. This is the reason we are having two different component here as a first component. Next step, we need to go for shifting operation. So we need to shift this S, we need to shift the L, we need to shift this, what else, capital L, two L's, this L and this L. This L has dollar, this L also leading to the same state dollar. Next, we need to shift capital R. Next, we need to shift star. Next, we need to shift ID. So with that, let us discuss or continue the same problem in the next class. If not, you can consider it as an assignment problem. So with that, let me complete today's session.